உதயராஜன், ஆர்கிடெக்ட், பிரின்சிபல் ஆர்கிடெக்ட் ஃப்ரம் விபி டிசைன் லேப். அண்ட் சதீஷ் வசந்த்குமார், அனதர் பிரின்சிபல் ஆர்கிடெக்ட் ஃப்ரம் விபி டிசைன் லேப். சின்ஸ் வி ஷேர் டிஃப்ரெண்ட் இன்ட்ரெஸ்ட் அண்ட் எவ்ரி ஒன் ஹேஸ் அ டிஃப்ரெண்ட் லைக்கிங் டு சம் ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் தேர் லைஃப், பிரிங்கிங் இன் தோஸ் ஆஸ்பெக்ட்ஸ் டு டிசைன் மேக்ஸ் இட் யூனிக் ஃபார் எவ்ரி ஈச் அண்ட் எவ்ரி ப்ராஜெக்ட். ஸோ தட்ஸ் ஹவ் ஆர் என்டையர் சிஸ்டம் ஒர்க்ஸ்.
Yeah, coming to this project is Anora Beach Resort. It's a client is like they are already into the hotel industry. They had a small resort in Kodaikanal. Like their brothers, like Rajesh Advani and Naresh Advani, they were planning to come up with this resort to sell the resort property at Kodaikanal and come and build a resort in Chennai. And they wanted a regular kind of a resort which they already had in their mind.
We realized that we are going to design a beach resort which is about 2 kilometers from the beach. So site is actually along the ECR road. So it was somewhere here. So it was something like this. So we didn't have any connect to the beach. So it's almost 2 kilometers from the beach. So now what we had to do is we have to create another artificial water body so that it behaves as a single element which around which the entire design could be evolved. This is how the entire site is. So this road, and it goes to the beach here, and this one is the national highway here. So we wanted to create a water body. Then we already have a lot of casuarina plantation that's been happening. So what we did is we first cleared off the entire plantation, and we found that we had about 3 to 4 palm trees exactly in the center of the site. So we wanted to use these two elements and work around these two elements to evolve the design. So we retained it, we created this water body, and then we started to work on the circulation part of it. So when it comes to circulation, being a resort, guest should feel that they are in a place where they could have a peaceful, serene walk. So that's how the resort should be. So we wanted to create such an ambience within the resort, but since it's almost the area is only about 1.9 acres. So what we did is we started working on certain circulation ideas. Considering this as a site, so we tried something square, we tried something like a channel kind of a thing. Then we finally ended up something in a curvilinear pattern. Once you start walking along the convex part of the curve, it creates a curiosity of what lies ahead. So that since you don't have a proper visual connectivity from the start to the end, that curiosity makes you even more the entire circulation, it makes it even more interesting. Whereas the concave part of it, you could see the start and the end point. So what we did is we started to orient our entire program along these curvilinear lines. So it was something like this. So the entire program was zoned in a circular curvilinear form. The programs were really heavy that we just have to segment it and arrange it based on the wind direction and climatological aspects. So what we did is we segmented the entire volume of the building. So it works something like this. So the buildings were arranged along the curvilinear lines. In a way, it helped us to convince the client that it is not a circular building. It's buildings arranged circularly, on a circular path. So this helped us to achieve two main things. That is, it helped us to have a proper ventilation across the buildings, between the buildings, and it focused on a common water body here. Everyone had an independent access to the water body. And another thing what we did is we started to stagger these blocks, because since it was a G+1 structure, it was very heavy sitting on the site. So we wanted to reduce the scale of the building, so we just pushed it down And this helped us to create a shaded platform in the ground floor, which was shaded continuously throughout the day. By moving the blocks in the first floor to the front, we created another volume here. So it works out something like this. So this is the ground plane. You have the first block here. The second block comes something like this. So we opened it this way and we had a swimming pool here, small plunge pool kind of a thing. And the first floor had a open bath. So what happened is, this entire portion is now open. And you have a deck here, and here the water body is coming up here. So now a cross ventilation is now been established within the building. So what happens is, the entire building is properly ventilated. You reduce the electrical AC loads into the building, and most of the time it remains cool. The entire circulation works out this way. This is the entrance to the site. So you come up this way and you have your reception here. From the reception, you can see what is happening here. Once you are done with all your regular bookings and other things, you are directed to come this way. So now your the convex part of the building, the diagrams what we were talking happens here. So once you come here, you have a void space which creates interest with portal frames happening here. So this captures the activities happening in this space. So again, every building has a small void space happening. And this is how the circulation goes and finally ends up in a restaurant. Only after this project we understood that unless and until architects go stand inside, understand how the laborers work, and then give them work, the building will turn up in a good way. Simple forms, when worked out on a very simple way, will lead to an effective space. So that is the major learning that we have learned from our building.